Do I have to move your fucking bike for you?
He forgot to take a picture of it.
Yeah.
A couple of weeks ago when we was here and we was like, bro, you all, I got a couple of phone calls. It was like people talking about they seen me down there at Venice.
Do you have time or what do you want to do?
You ain't blow me out.
I see a smile. I see a smile. both sides of the cheek beginning to show. Cheekbones rise, eyes twinkle, jaw relaxes. A smile! Blessings go into you. A loving glow spreads through you. Every cell inside you, upgraded by your happiness. A smile! Why we're not joyful and dancing? Because we're not thriving. Do you want to know why we're not thriving? Ah! Why'd you guys turn on the taser tape? Ah! It's exhausting when you're like that. Careful. Get away from the taser tape. I was trying to save you. I got electric unit, dude. Yeah. Holy shit. Never! I'm going to play and Care Bear Stare. My play and Care Bear Stare is going to awaken you. We can't afford to be humans anymore. If we do our meaning and purpose this way, we're not serving life needs. This doesn't work. Ecosystems work because it's based off needs. It's based off the vulnerable leading us. Because when the most powerful and when the most rich and when special interests lead us, then we have a world that doesn't work for most of us. It only really works for those in power. If we have a world that works for everyone, we must not look to owning, controlling. We must feel like we belong to. I don't own this land. I don't control it. I belong to it. I don't enforce rules. I attend to needs. You guys got this taser tape. Why would you put 10,000 volts on taser tape? This is inhuman. This is not nice to steer. Every day and attended to the needs that were up, we would need a lot more empathy. We would actually have time and space to wallow and vent, have our needs to be seen and known and understood. We have a need to make sense in the world. We have a need for unconditional belonging, which your job does not give you, unlike an ecosystem. And if we have to pay for shelter and food, then we're charging for life-sustaining needs, and we can't do this anymore because these are our biological, our psychological, our social, our fill-in-the-blank rights to exist. All of life. And because we have great power, we are the apex predators if we use our power over. But we're the superheroes if we use our power with. They might feel like I'm giving them unsolicited advice, so it might not be landing well, but speaking radical truth is the developmental stage I'm in, whether or not the information has been consented to. So if anyone feels like this is violence, just know it's been going on for years, and I'm learning and growing, finding better ways to do it. But let's all face it, we live in a world that doesn't work, so that's basically what we're doing. We're figuring it out because we don't know. So it's worth doing something really badly if it's important to do it. And also, we're going to be bringing chunks of soil, and we're going to plant a garden on Green Hill Night. Superheroes, how are you able to touch that tape and not get electrocuted? Do you guys have immunity? Do you know that some people have immunity to pepper spray? Is that why you have immunity? I think that you guys should do a doodle-do test before you go on every call. And a doodle-do test is when you look in the mirror or at your partner, you go doodle-doo-doo. And then you know if you're ready for the assignment, you laugh. So let's try it. Say doodle-doo-doo. Come on. If you don't pass the doodle-doodle test, I'm not going to be able to let you guys go.
I got all day.
I'm just kidding. I know better than your friend if you like him. Come on. All right, we'll do the doodle.
I'm always smiling. You know me. I'm always happy.
But just show him how it works. He might not know how it works. Ready? Yeah.
See, he's always smiling. Look.
I'll go first.
Like, see?
Dropped a love atomic bomb here in Venice Beach, where it's wild and free, and it goes and covers the whole wide earth. And we don't got rules and laws. We don't got wars. We don't got rules and laws. We don't got speciesism. We got ecosystem, which means we do our values, and then we acknowledge our behaviors, and then we decide do we like it, not like it. We mourn our actions we don't like. We positively reframe after we get empathy and love ourselves up. We don't blame and shame, because then we stay in the same cycle. And then we have a learning and growth mindset, because we're part of a tribe and we belong no matter what. White people got incredible trauma, where we got sent away to daycare and boarding school and then work, and we're always separate, and we gotta learn togetherness. And one more thing, superheroes, we must free the animals from the LA Zoo. Guys, I figured out how to stop crime. People are fighting because they're tired of seeing human after human. If we biodiversify and bring giraffes and flamingos and buffalo and pigs and other creatures, we must free them from the zoo, we will stop fighting each other. Hey, sweetheart, smile. Though your heart is breaking, smile.
We're gonna need some new wheels, aren't we?
It'll release oxytocin, smile. It'll make you conscious and creative, smile. It'll give you a proud chest and flare your tush.
All right.
If you're tucking your butt in, that means you feel shame. Take a deep breath and unclench your jaw. Superheroes, I'm not gonna tell you again. You don't have to work. Take off your uniforms. 911 is a call to love. I will not allow enforcers on this beach anymore. Only love crusaders. Remove your uniforms. Make a pile of guns. You guys are gonna get skateboards. make a pile of pepper spray. How on earth? Okay, bottom line, a lot of people are gonna come to Venice Beach because there's a lot of people who live outside and they're gonna start to know that Venice is wild and free and we can just garden and we're not gonna have a whole bunch of stuff. We're gonna have like big bins. So this weekend, they're gonna be giving away enough clothes for the whole year. Last year, I filled two giant bins with clothing, and remember I had that shelter for women? So any woman could come get clothes, and then we had another bin of dirty stuff, we wash it. No one owned anything. Just all the clothes were together. And then that way people like me who are good at organizing, I take care of the clothes. Everyone who's good at stuff does what they do. Most women I was with were slobs. So it makes sense that I would do all the organizing. This person would do all of this. This person would do all of that. And this is the type of community I want to create where there's willingness and people's capacities are being honored. And people are really having the experience of being seen, known, mattering, belonging, and being lovable no matter what, because you can't kick anyone off Earth. That's what's up.